possible outcomes that we can in the face of ongoing, unprecedented and sustained financial challenges. The final paragraph, sorry, the second to final paragraph offers a option in the event that the combined authority elected to pursue the mayoral model and then extended to fire rescue and police, and it is the option which we understand is under consideration in Greater Manchester, and that is set out within the report. The final point to make there is that irrespective of any of the governance arrangements, the Chief Fire Officer would retain delegated authority for all operational matters, because that is what we that is the case now. The only other point I would like to raise, members, is a paragraph 13, which is if the decision were taken to subsume Halton within the authority, that would require council tax across the two authority areas to be equalised. As it stands currently, our precept is £71.47. Jess's is £70.46. The difference is £1.01. Therefore, that is not an insurmountable issue to reconcile. That would be relatively straightforward to manage in financial terms. I'll pause at this point, Chair, because I'm conscious that this is an issue that is likely to generate some considerable interest within the authority. I'll take whatever questions that that members want to ask.
Thank you, Chair. We've all had briefings in our own authorities as to the implications. It's a brave new world. Any queries, questions, colleagues?
Just comment.
Go on, yes, please.
I just think this is the best way forward, option three.
Yes, I see.
Thanks, Chair. Thanks, Chair. I thank the Chief for presenting the report and the emails that's been from the from David Park on behalf of the City Region. Discussions that have engaged ourselves as the Fire and Rescue Authority about what we would like to see about what our ask would be in this new world of devolution. But, you know, we've got to recognise this is a government-driven agenda. It's still early days. This is the first phase of our asks between ourselves and the PCC. We've only had three options presented to us, and we feel that option three is the best as regards as our way forward and what we can give as part of the devolution agenda and what we can offer to the wider sort of changes through the financial challenges that we will be facing, working with the other emergency services, which we do a good job at the moment anyway. We do a fantastic job at the moment actually. And that could only benefit the public peers and our communities. But I think one of the decisions of Halton, as regards Halton, is that decision is out of our hands, it's out of our control. That is a matter directly for the district councils to determine, and maybe fall on, if there's no agreement, may fall on the hands of the government to make the overall decision on that. But as far as we go with the next stages for this, from what I've been informed is that the Liverpool City Region leaders will meet within the next week to discuss the responses back from the emergency services and agree or disagree on the proposals from ourselves and the other parties. And then that submission will then go to government, and then government will make a decision prior to the, or as part of the autumn statement, which is expected around the 20th of November. So then the combined authorities, so ourselves, Merseyside, Halton, Yorkshire, Newcastle, Birmingham, and the other cities, major cities, that have put in a bid for a combined authority status and metro mayor model, will be told then what the powers, duties, responsibilities will have, and what the timescale is likely to be for this package of new governance arrangements to be put in place, which is likely to be around May 2017. So in that time, in the next coming months anyway, whatever the outcome of the bid will be, and the confirmation from government in November, we will then have to have some long discussions about how the Fire and Rescue Authority will sit within this new governance model. And we'd hope that the Fire Authority as it is will continue, but maybe in a different form. but speaking to other colleagues, particularly in Greater Manchester, who are a bit more advanced than what we are, within their document, within their debt document, it does state the Greater Manchester Fire and Rescue Authority will be abolished, but alternative arrangements will be put in place. So we've been having some discussions with our colleagues in Greater Manchester to see how that would fit, because you think that whatever the outcome of their discussions with civil servants and ministers, that will follow through into a similar situation from other fire and rescue authorities across the country, because why have anything different if they agree on that? So we have a lot of conversations to be had, the chief and myself, with the city council, with the relevant officers involved with that, to ensure that we do the best we can and ensure that we protect what we can for the authority and for the service as we go forward. Because, you know, there's been a lot of speculation and rumours about where we're going as a service. And we're a fantastic service. We're very efficient, we're very effective. That was prepared today from our auditors at Thornton. You know, we are very much public sector, that's value for money. And we deliver an excellent service. And all our staff should be thanked for that, for their contribution for that. It shouldn't be forgotten. But it's that uncertainty, I think, that sort of lies or comes over everybody's head about where we see the future, because the financial challenges are not going to change. There's still going to be difficult decisions to be made in the next coming years. But on top of that, you know, if you think about where will the service and the authority be, will it become part of the combined authority, will it become part of the PCC, will it become part of something other model? We don't know. So I think for our interest and the interest of the service, it will be better for us to align ourselves with the future compliance authority model, where at least we will continue as an authority or committee. We will still have elected members to make those decisions. We will still be responsible for the IRMP. We will still be responsible for settlements, albeit that the elected mayor will have overall responsibility for that. But I'm sure that any mayor, whoever that may be, would consult closely with the committee for authority as it will be in the future. But I think as we go forward, Chair and members, you know, I can give you our assurances that we'll do all we can to protect the autonomy of the authority. We'll protect the service as best we can, because, you know, part of you feels as if, you know, what's this government's agenda? Is it to abolish the fire and rescue service altogether? Is it to pass that responsibility to somebody else? Is it to downgrade the service? Is it to sell it off piecemeal? We don't know. So we have an obligation to make sure that the service that we deliver to our communities, to our residents, is second to none. It's a first class service, and it's the envy of the world, and long may that continue.
Okay. So, unless there's any other points or questions, the recommendation is that members approve the response which is set out in this report. Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Well, thank you, colleagues. We shall see what happens next.